Hey everybody, it's Kenbuck Racing here, and we're gonna play a little more of Endless Space 2. So I was thinking of just starting new with what I know already from the previous, since I was kind of just messing around in screens before, but I think I'm actually just gonna play a little more on the save that I started, just to see, because like it, I feel like I could quickly spiral down a path of like play a little, restart, play a little more, restart again. I'd rather just go into this, learn as much as I can about it while I go, and restart later. So for now, I do really like the Lumeris theme music, like that noir kind of sound. Super, super cool, super chill. So how are the peeps? I actually did a Smash tournament today. I placed 9th out of 32. So pretty happy about that. I played Mewtwo more than anything, actually. been kind of giving Yoshi a break. Just because, like, I feel like I've been making a lot of mistakes with Yoshi lately, so giving myself some time off. Alright, so what was I trying to do here? Looks like I have this guy just kind of chilling. There's nothing really to search here. I guess there's nothing stopping me from going through here now, huh? No, there isn't. Looks like there's another ship there. I might as well send them just to get a lay of the land. What is that? Why is there a thing over that? Oh, that's a resource. That's okay. So I really want this tiny tropical here. However, it is pretty close to their territory, and I've got a lot of tundras over here I could take. I'm already working on this. How long was that again? 2 turns, and I'll be able to. Oh, I'll get that. It might be worth throwing some dust at it, actually, to make it faster. This will be a good system for me to do. Oh, this will actually be a great system for me, with all the dust. And what am I trying to do here? I guess I'm trying to pick up enough influence to assimilate these guys. There's actually 2 different factions I could assimilate. Where are they? I'm not sure where you see the minor factions. I'm looking around here for it. Maybe I click on the system? No. Can I click up here? There? Okay, so I click there. Alright. So this is what I want to do, but I need xenobiology. And that is next on the docket. I wonder how many I'm allowed, because I know there's another one somewhere. I don't remember where he was. I encountered him somewhere over here, but that's fine. Oh shoot, that's why I wasn't moving him, is because I was going to make him go over here. I was just waiting this couple of turns. That's alright. I mean, I don't think they're going to attack me, or I'm not sure they even can, honestly. Probably don't have much of a military. I will soon. I guess we'll just end the turn. Okay, so I should have a new fleet. There we go. Let's, create a fleet. I would really like another hero. However, I don't know if I can do that. Check the probabilities to determine what type it would be. Huh. So am I allowed to, like, can I hire it? Or do I need the, hyper packs first? I don't know if I need the embassy. Let's see. This embassy enables a legendary outfit to gain an administrative foothold in your empire. To monitor your empire's readiness for their heroes. Heroes such as the brilliant Maverick Cracked-Cubed Police, who expect certain standards. Okay. Enables unlock of new heroes. Seems very important. So why is it all the way down on 6? Oh, well, I guess it's because of Astro Finance, huh? 3. Let's try. Oh boy. This is why I keep thinking I need to, why I'm so tempted to restart, because I have trouble figuring out what order I should research things for this. Yeah, I want xenobiology. And then I want that. And then I want xenobotany. And then we'll go astrofinance. Xenology. Though what would be really nice would be having, more science stuff. Oh, I forgot about this guy up here. I mean, yeah, that would be really important, too. But rather than... I don't want to go super, super far down the road of analysis paralysis here. Not yet, anyway. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this guy. I guess just have him guard here. See if he gets through without attracting attention. Looks like he got through. Okay, we see something here. I love how this comes up. Desert is very interesting. There's some steps. Red Sang. Okay, this is actually a very good system for me. How easy would it... Oh, it's not that easy to get, I suppose. Is there anything here I can colonize right now? No. Wait, arid epigenetics for snow? Sounds odd. I don't have any more probes, huh? So I'm gonna want to send, probably just throw a probe down this way while I investigate here. He's not idle. I told him to guard. He's doing something. He's just here to tell me that's done. Alright, let's move on. Okay. So now, I could... Oh, cool. I got my colony. Let's get this started, then. That would be first. Infinite supermarkets would be great. Same with... Oop, not that, sorry. I wanted this. Which I guess that's actually faster, so... Yeah, there we go. That sounds good. Now for this, what I could do is colonize it and then sell it to those guys up there. Let's do it. Oh, look at that. Yeah, so that other one I made didn't count. That kind of sucks. Well, I'm sure, you know, early access kind of stuff. But this guy's gonna be pissed. But hey, I'm totally willing to sell it to them. Population gained. Okay, I did that. We're working on xenobiology. So that means I'll be able to assimilate that guy soon. We're gonna go ahead and launch a probe this direction. And then I'll just leave the scout here. I'm gonna investigate this a little more. Found a star here. Cancer, medium gas burning. Well, that's all that's there. Going on here. Xenobot. Okay, yeah, I definitely need xenobotany so that I can open this up. How do I know? I don't know how long until this slot opens. Like, on the first endless space, there was something that told you how many turns. I think it's this over here, isn't it? Turns until gain. Yeah, okay, so next turn I'm gonna go up to 5. Yeah, so the sooner I get Tundra, the better, because then I could, Huh. Interesting. I just realized the potential downfall to these guys. So, in Endless Space 1... What I would do, once my population would, like, cap out, I would build a colony ship so that I could, even if I wasn't colonizing a new system, I would use it to move it to an existing colony, just so that, you know, so this one, for example, would be constantly growing, excuse me, and... any surplus colony would be shipped out to some other world. This faction can't do that, since they don't build colony ships. I would never be able to move population around like that. I could do it within the system, but not to a different system. I might be wasting my time with these, honestly. Like, I'm kind of thinking I should just get on with these. But having some form of military just makes me feel a little bit better. Since I have met pirates, you know. Let's move this guy out here, see what we find. It's another convoy. I'm just kind of floating out. That guy's moving, he's chilling. Yeah. Okay. They're also up to five. Who's idle? Yeah, you're supposed to be idle. Whoa. Alright. Weird noises. Ooh, new hero. Okay, the Cravers look pretty cool up close. Maris and Sylphons. They all look really cool up close. Overseer focuses on system-wide resources and fleet development. Industrialists. We have a Guardian, focuses on fleet warfare and industrial production. Well, that's what he did. System-wide res... not the same. Kind of like him better, but I don't have any ecologists. We have this another overseer. System-wide resources and fleet development. So, you know, I kind of prefer the Sophon guy, because he's going to be science-based, I'm sure. And I feel like I need a boost in my science. I don't know what all of these are. Oh, wit. This implies the hero is focused on trade, diplomacy, and empire resources. This is labor, focused on system resource output. Trade deployment. There's command, commanding fleets and improving chance of winning battles, and wanderlust, focused on exploration, movement, and galaxy actions. So this guy is he's a labor wanderer, it seems. This is labor command. This guy is very labor. He's labor. Very interesting. Oh, shit. I think I maybe? I might understand? It looks like it's a skill cap. Huh. Interesting. I know I'm taking forever to make decisions. This is my first time, I don't really know what I want. I kinda like the idea of a Sophon, but that 017 sounds really freaking good. You put him in a, system-wide resources and fleet development, you put him... I mean, your production's gonna shoot through the roof with something like that. That might be the way to go. I mean, yeah, he's also an overseer. And he's a Sophon, so he probably gets science-related bonuses, which is what I want. But 017 sounds very, very powerful. So I think I'm gonna go with him. Hiring this hero will appoint him or her to the political leader of the Industrialists' political party. Do it. So they went to the political party, eh? Okay, I see. Interesting. I have 116. Yeah, so I can't enact any of these. Which one would I want? 50% dust on systems. I kinda really like that. Plus 3 dust per dude, minus 1 happiness. Might want to save up for the Super Tax Act, actually. Okay. So, what I've done... Yeah, we have a governor here. Interesting. How did those get boosted? So it's not through skill points. 10 dust per anomalies on colonized planet, 10 dust on system, 10 dust on system. Okay. The Altruan Order's parents were scientists dispatched to a deep space research station. So he never knew the life and culture of your average Lumerian child. Instead, Yelchin grew up playing in the desolate remains of the Endless. Ancient runes and whispering computers were as much his friends as the other scientists. Visits to the homeworld were awkward and uncomfortable for the young Lumerian, who knew nothing of trade or deal-making, but everything to do with the names and records of Endless scientists, soldiers, and scholars. When his parents mistakenly awakened in an ancient... Wait, when his parents mistakenly awakened in... Oh, I don't know how I threw the word in there. When his parents mistakenly awakened an ancient Endless security system, Yelchin willingly raced to the heart of the facility to shut down the ancient power core. He succeeded, but in the process was exposed to a tidal wave of pure dust that was vented into the room. His head now filled with far more than Endless Arcana, and in need of somebody who could help him understand his new powers, he sought out the Academy. Now Yelchin is caught between two worlds, the mundane world of the people he is supposed to call kin and the mysterious realm of the long-dead Endless. Cool. I'm kind of thinking. So we want high production. What do we have between these two worlds? This one is... It seems like this one is better suited to dust. Well, definitely for food, actually. Actually, I guess that extra dust could be from... Yelchin. 6333. See what this is down here. This is giving me 4655. That's also... Ooh, heavy production here eventually. So really, I guess putting... I was thinking of moving him up there, but... This makes sense. Yeah, we'll assign him there. Okay, yeah, so that all went up. Cool. And what are his bonuses? +2 production per person? I don't have anything out there yet. Okay. I don't really get how this works yet, but that's alright. Oh yeah, what do these do? So overseer specific skills are +10% manpower refill rate, +1 deposit value on resource, that's cool, +10% shield capacity on fleet, 10 food on system, 10 production on system, -25%. The bottom one looks like colonization resistance, or colonization disapproval. I don't know what the top one is. I bet that's overpopulation disapproval. Never see your hero runs a tight ship, even when not actually on a ship. Everything runs like clockwork. Even the densest urban centers in the most sprawling empires feel a little less chaotic to live in. Yeah, so I'm gonna guess that's overpopulation and colonization disapproval. Then we have bean counter. +10% on production, food, and dust. That's pretty cool. Alright, so what does the craver do? Blunt force trauma. The hero raids the ruins... Wait, in a bit of unconventional craver thinking, the hero raids the ruins of a long-devoured civilization and steals weapons research for their personal fleet, boosting kinetic and missile damage. Okay. We also have... forced labor. So +10 production and +5 food on system per planet. The hero orders the capture and incarceration of creatures from other factions, gang-pressing them into system-wide service in factories and on farms. They'll be spared and rewarded for their work until the planets they toil on are stripped bare of all resources. Yikes. Space adaptation, fleet health, and probe recovery rate. That's nice. This is influence. 20% damage, 25% defending troops' health. And plus 5 depletion points on planets. Plus 20% on depleted planets. Cool. Which doesn't really... It's not really going to do anything for me. Well, I guess it could. Huh. I guess that could help. If I go and take over a Kraven world that has been depleted. Using them in battle right now. Yeah, so we'll start with those. This guy is working on... You know, I'm kind of thinking... Do this. We can spread these. Which one's more? They're both the same. Get this down. Get that one down here. It's still 41 turns to do that? Damn. Over time, I'll gain population, so it'll be cool. Alright. So let's take a look at my ships. This guy's not doing anything. Oh yeah, move everybody. I don't remember what he was doing. I think he's just kind of chilling here. He's just kind of chilling. He's just patrolling this spot. And I'll probably do that here, too. Put a guy here to patrol that. Though, with the, being able to move anywhere, might not matter. You know, speaking of, we don't have anything to do up here. Oh, this is where these guys are, huh? Oh, these are only 75? Maybe the other one was only 75. Oh, but they're aggressive towards me for some reason. They don't like me, huh? What about these other guys? I mean, they're alright. It's going down, but... 6 Terrans, eh? They should still be in the green by the time I get that done. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and explore some of that stuff before... Who is this? Oh, that's him. Assign skills. Does he have skills? No, not yet. this. Level on system 1 times... Cool. I want to see his overview. Being as expected, loyalty must be induced. Unbound learns to obtain uncompromising control over their drones by creating and exuding more potent pheromones. Transformed by dust when gutting an endless temple, he now uses their increased expertise to generate a sort of dust-enhanced near-chemical dependence among any sentient troops he leads. Ew. Unbound has now become not just a clever leader, but one supported by fanatical soldiers who are indifferent to danger and injury. Huh. Scary. I don't think I'm really doing anything else. This guy's just chilling. I mean, I actually could scout around with him. And why not, you know? I don't really see a whole lot happening. I might as well. Honestly, like, I might as well scout with him. I know he doesn't have a probe, but... I feel kind of silly, like, just having him sit there. But that is, like, the strategic value. Speaking of, how close two turns? Well, that's right there. Yeah, I don't know. I guess I kind of want to keep scouting. It's this. Latest political survey. It appears a pacifist is in the lead, but who knows what might happen election day. Political surveys are important tools for understanding likely results of forthcoming elections. If you want to get a better idea of the political support in systems, zoom into Star System Management P for system in question and activate Scan by pressing spacebar. In 5 turns, your empire will see its first election. It's interesting. I don't quite know what happens. But we'll see. Law and policies. For the pacifist, law and policies that promote peace between races not only minimize bloodshed, but simultaneously strengthen economical and cultural wealth. Under this ideology, your population will support stances that oppose warfare. Prosperity through peace. It affects the kind of heroes you get. Oh, that's what's supported by it. Trading, friendly diplomacy, and empire encounter. Then we have industrialists. Industrialists believe that progress is something that happens brick by brick, system by system. Problems of hunger, pollution, and education are treated with improved factories, better technologies, and more advanced schools. Advanced societies can build their way out of problems. Alright. That's cool. Still don't quite understand it, but that's okay. I don't have to right now. I'm just waiting to check those out. I really don't want to just leave him here. Is there anywhere I can throw a probe? Not really. Oh, I haven't actually looked at this yet. Dark glitter. Dark glitter. Clouds of glittering particles that react to warp movement. Ah, it's some kind of resource, huh? There isn't really anything here to study, so I'm gonna leave. Are there stuff to explore? Yeah, there are a couple things to explore down there. Economy scan. Oh, that's weird. Huh. That's cool. We're gonna move him. Get him the hell out of here. Let's send him down here. And I'm just curious what would happen. Talk to you. Talk about selling this. Is that gonna cost me anything? I'm not even sure. I should say they're real happy with it. Oh. Why is that 45? Why would it cost 45 to make that offer? 38 plus 8 is 46. I wonder if it's 45 plus 38 is going to be what I have to pay in influence. I mean, there's no way I'm going to do it for that price, of course. They're not really going to like it. Let's back out. I mean, I think that's what I'm supposed to be doing with these guys. Maybe it's too early, though. 6 turns till xenobiology. What's he doing? Nothing, he's just waiting for more probes. Alright, next turn. You. Alright. Your career is enough to influence to pass your first law. There's a new miner. They are a pacifist. Art of science. And something else. Where are they? Ah! Right there. Scavenging pirates. So what's this? Oh, he's gonna get blown up if I keep him there. Oh, it's a good thing this guy is on his way. What's his movement? Do I know? 4. Can I get there in time? Wish I could see how many spaces were on that. It'll take 3 turns to get here, huh? I mean, I might be able to play real defensive, but I'm not real sure. Let's see how close he's not going to get there this turn, so we'll just see how close he gets. What am I going to look at? Like, this is an awesome planet, and I want it. So let's look at the steps first. I feel like this is going to be easier to get to than this. Just doesn't matter. I mean, I'm going to check them all anyway. Life form. Alright, we found Red Sang. And plus 5 loot. Cool. Ooh. One of the planets in the system at first appears to be lifeless and poor in resources. A second scan at higher power, however, reveals that the entire planet is a hologram, and in fact there is something hiding beneath the cleverly constructed camouflage. Perhaps you can figure out just how the camouflage works. I'm more interested in what's in there. I could analyze the planet. It's minus 10 science on Empire, but it increases scientist political ideology. And I don't... Problem is, I don't have a scientist political party right now. I wonder if something would happen at the end of those 10 turns, though. It's a shame, because it seems really cool. It seems like the kind of thing where maybe something would happen afterwards. But I don't know. Minus 10 science for 10 turns. It's really gonna hurt me, too. But I don't have a scientist political ideology. Can I... Okay, I can minimize this. Hang on a sec. Let me take a look. Yeah, it's not gonna... This isn't any good. Laws are broken down into 6 political categories. Crucially, you're only able to pass laws from a particular category if you have representation for that category. The active laws pane, click on the pass laws button to see what's available. Yeah. Laws apply to your whole empire with immediate effect, so are a powerful means of supporting strategic changes. The staying force provides the required support is maintained in the Senate. Huh. I mean, that's a pretty good one right there, right? But I'm also really close to being able to get that assimilation, which I'd really like. Ten 10 per peace on systems, 10 per alliance. Well, right now I'm at Cold War, so it really doesn't help me at all, right? I don't think Cold War counts as peace. I'm not sure. I actually don't know. I would rather save up for... I really want the Super Tax Act, honestly. I mean, that would be a good one, too. But I actually don't... I don't want to do this at all. This one... It sounds really cool, but I think I'm going to ignore it. Spend science to try and learn more about what lies beneath. Or your explorers decide whatever might be there isn't worth it. You know, that does sound like there could be something else behind it. I'm really curious, because that's a really cool sounding event. Perhaps you can figure out just how the camouflage worked. I mean, that's really gonna hurt my science. And there's nothing... Not today. We're gonna say no. It sounded cool, but... I just don't see much of a use for it right now. Red Sang. You can use it to upgrade your systems. Oh yeah. Not telling me how... I don't understand how this works. Effects within a system development upgrade. Wait. Effects within a system development upgrade. I need neural robotics, huh? Commercial frameworks. Where are these technologies hiding, anyway? One was neural something. Neural robotics? Yeah, this. That's cool. And, what was the other one? Survival suits. New government types are there. I already don't remember what it was called. I don't see it. Yeah, what is this? Reveals and enables use of... Oh, so you actually can't even see the wormholes. Until you get that. Yeah, I don't remember what that was. Neural robotics and commercial frameworks. Look again. Commercial frameworks, where is it? Oh, it's down here. There we go. Okay. Cool. So that's my Red Sang. What's this? Yeah, I found them. Outpost alert on Turkana. Where's that? Oh, okay. Interesting. So I may need to spend a little bit of, I don't need to do it yet. I'm absorb 50% food from adjacent colonized star systems. From adjacent colonized stars. I wonder if that's... I don't know if that means me or them. It's 10 food. I could spend some... I think that's probably a good idea, honestly. Absorb 10 food each turn from opponent's outposts. That sounds pretty good. She's on the irradiated one. Yeah, let's do that. There we go. Cool. Let's be a jerk. Did take a big chunk of manpower, but that's okay. I was gonna try to sell it to her, but... Man, she wanted to be... just being picky. I need hypersipers. Yeah, we really need... Oh, what is this? Evaporation inhibitors. Not sure what that is. And regolith processing. I did see that one. Hypersipers is right here. It wasn't this one. This is for snow. Jungle, swamp. Is there anything here? No. Regolith processing is all the way out here. Ultra deep, that's Arctic. Oh yeah, this is 3 as well. Colonize ocean. Huh. Alright, what can he do? Did he move yet? No. No, that guy did not. He did not move yet. I think we're good. I'm not going to be able to see it. What's going on here? Oh boy. There's 2? I'm not going to be able to survive that. Prowler? Isn't this a pirate? That is not a pirate. That's a... Huh. So she already has someone assimilated. Well, okay, here's my action. We're gonna have to get the hell out of Dodge. 25% health recovered at end of battle. Yeah. That's problematic. How soon until this is... Okay, this is done. How does she already have this much? I guess I did go for the wrong... start, but geez. I can create a fleet. Seem kind of a little bit lame, honestly. Let's go with this one again. Bam. He's gonna chill right here for now? Because I don't know what's gonna happen here. I don't know that I just want to go out though either. She dumped a bunch of dust into activating that gold thing. Which is fine for me, because I should actually still be leeching 10 food each turn off of it. And that's plus 10. So actually, all she's doing is undoing the damage I've already dealt. I'm still gonna beat her. That's funny. I wonder if she's a little more receptive to buying that. Oh, that's weird. Oh, maybe I can't do that if she's already, yeah, if someone else is, I guess if someone else is on it, then I can't. Interesting. They look cool. Well, I think that's it. This guy's chilling. I mean, I don't know how much I want him to be chilling, because his health is kind of low. And that guy's going to appear soon. This one is chilling as well. Alright, let's just go. Hopefully he gets there first. Shit. Oh, there are two here? Oh my god. Oh, there is a retreat button, huh? I guess not. Well, that sucks. I didn't know there were two there. Wait, what am I looking at? Oh, he still has probes? I didn't realize that. Huh. I mean, you might as well take a look at, might as well throw a probe at it. It's hollow planet and plus 5 manpower. Cool. Man, I just feel so... I feel severely underpowered. Like... like, I don't know, man. Like, something's not gelling here. I'm having trouble making the connections I need to, and... it's starting to get beat up a lot. I think I want to restart now. Like, I'm just finding myself in this position where... I'm, like, trying to defend myself with scout ships. Rather than, like, actual gunships. I think starting with that technology first really screwed me. There's a butt hunt.
Are you strumming?
I am strumming. Camera though.
What?
What's that? What kind of stone is that?
It's a quartz.
Is it? Oh, that's nice. Oh, I like this one. I don't have my camera on it, otherwise I'd shoot.
But I need a buffer
drop it
for.
For this stuff down here.
Well, that one doesn't need it, but some of them were sharp.
Oh, that's just dust or something.
So, yeah, that's close. So I sanded it, but it's kind of like a rough sanding.
I think, you know why? Because it kind of matches the texture of the rock itself. Like, if it were a very smooth stone, I'd say, get your buffer.
Damn, it's super sharp. I need more solder.
Already?
I went through about half of it.
I was gonna say, it didn't look like it was gonna...
And the tip of my solder, like, at first it was like a needle, it's, like, half gone. It, like, melts away with the solder.
With the soldering iron?
Yeah.
Huh.
So, I'm gonna... You can replace them easy. I'm sure if I can just get a bunch in bulk.
Cool.
I can charge a lot more for these.
Yeah. I like them.
You can charge a lot for these ones.
Yeah.
Because the one I got today, it was glass. And she charged me 30 for it. So these are real. I'm going to charge about 40 for these.
Yeah, I would. It's pretty nice.
My throat hurts. I didn't realize it until just now.
No. But I love you.
I love you.
Okay. So we are going to set this game aside. And I'm going to start a new one. Quick game. I actually just kind of want to see where I stand. I'm not doing as poorly as this guy. Oh wow, look at that. I was actually... Huh. I was actually in first? Why do I feel so far behind, though? What actually blew me up? You know, maybe I'm misreading something. The thing that blew me up, it did say Wandering Fleet, and I was assuming it was something of hers, but I could be wrong. I'm really not sure. But yeah, my overall score was at the top, so I was doing something right. You know, I feel like this was my problem in Endless Legend, too, where I was actually doing well, but I constantly felt behind. And I think it's just because there's so many things that I want to do, and I'm not getting to them fast enough, and I just constantly feel like I'm playing at a slower pace than I need to. But really, overall, like, I was, you know, again, like, up there with the other Lumeris. Industry... Oh, my industry sucked. Dust was not doing so well. Wow, she took a big jump somehow. What happened there? She must have found an event. And this is exactly where my problem was. Just my science was just not going anywhere. I had no influence. My population was doing alright. Yeah, my research sucks. There was no trade yet. Approval was okay. Expansion, huh? I think that's me up there somewhere. I'm not sure. Heroes. It's a weird curve right there. In military. Whoa. How'd the blue guy, like, take such a big jump? Looks like he found something. Okay, well, I got a little bit of a taste of the Lumeris.